Welcome to this performance of the St. John Passion by Bob Chilcott. It's very good that you've been able to join us on this Good Friday. Very big thank you to everyone who's been involved in putting this together, not least Ben Vomberg-Clark, who's brought the many dozens of musicians together for this wonderful work. Let us pray. Lord Jesus Christ, you have taught us that what we do for the least of our brothers and sisters, we do also for you. Give us the will to be the servant of others, as you were the servant of all, and gave up your life and died for us, but are alive and reign now and forever. Amen.
Jesus went forth with his disciples over the brook Kidron, where was a garden into the which he entered and his disciples. Judas then, having received a band of men and officers from the chief priests and Pharisees, cometh thither with lanterns and torches and weapons. Jesus, therefore, knowing all things that should come upon him, went forth and said unto them, "You seek him." They answered him, and soon then, as he had said unto them, "I am he," they went backward and and fell to the ground. Then asked he them again,
"Whom seek ye?"
And they said, Simon Peter, having a sword, drew it and smote the high priest's servant and cut off his right ear. The servant's name was Malchus. Then said Jesus unto
thy sword into the sheath. The cup which my Father hath given me, shall I not drink it?
Then the band and the captain and officers of the Jews took Jesus and bound him and led him away to Annas first, for he was the father-in-law to Caiaphas, which was the high priest that same
year. Thank you.
Caiaphas was he which gave counsel to the Jews that it was expedient that one man should die for the people. And Simon Peter followed Jesus, and so did another disciple. That disciple was known unto the high priest, and went in with Jesus into the palace of the high priest. But Peter stood at the door without. Then went out that other disciple, which was known unto the high priest, and spake unto her that kept the door, and brought in Peter. Then saith the damsel that kept the door unto Peter, servants and officers stood there who had made a fire of coals, for it was cold, and they warmed themselves, and Peter stood with them and warmed himself. The high priest then asked Jesus of his disciples and of his doctrine. Jesus answered him,
I spake openly to the world. I ever taught in the
the high priest, and Simon Peter stood and warmed himself. They said therefore unto him, servants of the high priest, being his his kinsman, whose ear Peter cut off, said,
Did not I see thee in the garden with him?
Peter then denied again.
Thank you.
Then led they Jesus from Caiaphas unto the hall of judgment, and it was early. And they themselves went not into the judgment hall, lest they should be defiled, but that they might eat the Passover. Pilate then went out unto them, and said,
What accusation bring ye against this man?
They answered and said unto him, Then said Pilate unto them,
Take ye him, and judge him according to your law.
The Jews therefore said unto him,
It is the law for us, brought us to the cross, and it bears to death.
That the saying of Jesus might be fulfilled, which he spake, signifying what death he should die. Then Pilate entered into the judgment hall again, and called Jesus, and said unto him,
But thou, the King of the Jews?
Jesus answered him,
Sayest thou this thing of thyself, or did others tell it thee of me?
Answered,
Am I the Jew? Thine own nation and the chief priests have delivered thee unto me. What hast thou done?
Jesus answered,
My kingdom is not of this world. If my kingdom my servants fight, that I should not be delivered to the Jews. But now is my kingdom not from
Pilate therefore said unto him,
Art thou a king then?
Jesus answered,
Thou sayest that I am a king. To this end was I born, and for this cause came I into the world, that I should bear witness unto the truth.
And saith unto them,
I find in him no fault at all, but he hath a custom that I should release unto you one at the Passover. Will ye therefore that I release unto you the King of the Jews?
They cried they all again, saying,
O Christ,
and scourged him, and scourged him. And the soldiers plaited a crown of thorns and put it on his head, and they put on him a purple robe, and said,
King of the Jews, King of the Jews.
And they smote him with their hands. Pilate therefore went forth again, and saith unto them,
Behold, I bring him forth to you, that ye may know that I find no fault in him.
Then came Jesus forth, Jesus forth, wearing the crown of thorns and the therefore, and officers saw him, they cried out, saying,
Crucify him, crucify him, crucify him.
Pilate saith unto them,
Take him and crucify him, for I find no fault.
The Jews answered him,
We have a law that binds for he holds to God, because he made himself the Son of God.
heard that saying, he was the more afraid, and went again into the judgment hall and saith unto Jesus,
Whence art thou?
But Jesus gave him no answer. Then saith Pilate unto him,
Speakest thou not unto me, nor hast thou not that I have power to crucify thee, and have power to release thee?
Jesus answered,
Thou couldest have no power at all against me, except it were given thee from above. Therefore he that delivered me unto thee
and from thenceforth Pilate sought to release him. But the Jews cried out, saying,
"If the man is the Lord, how long will Caesar's bread? Whosoever maketh his own the king, speak them like a Caesar."
When Pilate therefore heard that saying, he brought Jesus forth, and sat down in the judgment seat in a place that is called the pavement, but in the Hebrew Gabbatha. And it was the preparation of the Passover, and about the sixth hour, and he saith unto the Jews,
"Behold your king."
But they cried out,
"Away with him, crucify him, crucify him, crucify him."
Pilate said unto them,
"Shall I crucify your king?"
The chief priests answered,
"We have no king, we have no king, but Caesar."
This title then read many of the Jews, for the place where Jesus was crucified was nigh to the city, and it was written in Hebrew and Greek and Latin. Then said the chief priests of the Jews to Pilate, then the soldiers, when they had crucified Jesus, took his garments and made four parts, to every soldier a part, and also his coat. Now the coat was without seam, woven from the top throughout. They said, therefore, among themselves,
let us not rend it, but cast lots for it, whose it shall be.
That the scripture might be fulfilled, which saith, they parted my raiment among them, and for my vesture they did cast lots. These things therefore the soldiers did. Now there stood by the cross of Jesus his mother and his mother's sister, Mary, the wife of Cleophas, and Mary Magdalena. When Jesus therefore saw his mother and the disciples standing by, whom he loved, he saith unto his mother,
thy son.
and put it to him.